Hello friends, today I will discuss the Ajax Watt vertical core type induction furnace. Here I will consider the following points: necessity, definition, principle, construction, operation, disadvantages and advantages. To understand this furnace properly, first I will consider this furnace with core type transformer, then we will consider the Ajax Watt furnace with the original transformer, that is cell type of transformer. What is the necessity of this furnace? Its main purpose is to melt the metals, hardening, soldering, melting the non-ferrous metals also. And coming to the definition of this, it is nothing but a method of heating the metal by electromagnetic induction. Coming to the principle, here when primary coil is connected to AC supply, currents are induced in the charge to be heated by electromagnetic induction. Coming to the construction, it consists of a single phase cell type transformer, a primary coil connected to single phase 600 volts 50 hertz supply, and it will also consist of V-shape crucible with inner lining, and the inner lining will have the clay for yellow brass and it will have the rundum for red brass, and it will have the magnetic core, and it will also have the molten charge which acts as the singleton secondary winding. There is magnetic coupling between primary and the crucible, and the on top of the furnace there is a insulated cover, that is also called lid, which is used to pour the charge with the help of the mechanical arrangement that we can see here. This is the core type transformer. Core type transformer means core will is surrounded by the windings. So that is core is inside, windings are outside. So this charge, whatever is present in this crucible, this is nothing but crucible. This is here it is V-shaped crucible. In this we pour the molten metal in this, so it should be always there to work this furnace. So over this we pour the charge to be melted, and here this is the core of the core type transformer. And this is the primary winding, and which will be connected to the 600 volts 50 hertz single phase supply. So when we give the AC supply to this primary winding, what happens is a flux will be produced because of this current in the core. This flux links with the crucible, which is in the form of a V shape, and then the currents induced in this crucible transfers the heat to the charge by convection method. Then that heat will be transferred to the rest of the metal to be heated. The same thing we can also see in the original Ajax Watt furnace, where the transformer is cell type transformer, that is the core surrounds the windings, that is here the winding means this is the primary winding and this is the refractory lining which I covered, this is the V channel. And here in this V channel we pour the molten metal which acts as the secondary winding for this furnace. it should be always there. And above this, we pour the metal to be melted. And this is the top lid or door from which we place the charge into this to heat it. After heating, we get the charge collected from this by opening this lid with the help of mechanical arrangement. So this is nothing but core of the transformer, cell type transformer. So when it comes to the current, due to the interaction of secondary current with the AC magnetic field at above 500 amperes per square centimeter current density, the turbulence will occur in the charge that leads to the interruption of secondary circuit. This phenomena is called pinching effect, but due to the large amount of the charge above the this V-shaped portion, that is this, the interruption of the secondary will never occur in this furnace. And moreover, because of the stirring action at higher frequency, that is 50 Hz, so the heat transfers to the whole metal uniformly. So we get the uniform melted metal from this furnace. Coming to the disadvantages with the furnace is it is not suitable for intermittent service. That is, it is suitable for continuous service. The second point is to start and run the furnace, it requires a molten metal in the V portion of the furnace. That is to form the secondary or to have the secondary always. And coming to the advantages, due to the electromagnetic force, heating of metal is uniform at 50 Hz. And its operation is very rapid, so melting is very easy and it is also clean. And it is easy to control the temperature of this furnace. And because of the good magnetic coupling between the primary winding and the charge, the power factor range will be 0.8 to 0.85. And coming to the other advantage, the pinching effect is absent in this furnace. Coming to the sixth point, and it is easy to pour melting metal by mechanical arrangement.